Now, so far, it looks a bit as if we've been shifting everything over to the relative side. We've not got anything absolute left. But Hermann Minkowski, who was one of Einstein's professors in Zurich, who famously branded Einstein as being a lazy dog because he hadn't attended his lectures, changed his mind after he read Einstein's publications because he realized how important they were, and he was one of the first people to give him recognition for that. And what Minkowski showed was that you could represent Einstein's results graphically. We're all familiar with taking a set of x, y, and z axes like this, and we can represent any point in space by a coordinate relative to that. And if we rotate the axes, the coordinates change, even though the point itself hasn't moved. What Minkowski said is Einstein's equations are saying that we can add a fourth axis to these x, y, and z, a time axis. Now, in orbit space, I can't find any other axis perpendicular to all three of those, but if I had a four-dimensional space, I could have another time axis. And in that four-dimensional space, moving is equivalent to rotating these axes in four-dimensional space, so time and space get mixed up together. And Minkowski showed that there was a distance between two points, which he called the space-time interval, delta x squared plus delta y squared plus delta z squared minus c squared delta t squared, which is the same for all observers. That is an absolute quantity, so that replaces the relative length and time with an absolute space-time interval that is the same for all observers. Thank you.